everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. So as you can see, we have made these beautiful coasters with the help of Transforme sheets. What we are going to do is, today we are going to learn one of these Transforme sheets coaster. By doing one, you will be able to do all of them because they have similar techniques, and if you have any problem, you can always get in touch later on with us. So what all you need for the same coaster? You need an MDF base or maybe a wooden base of coaster. What you need is, you need some of your distress crayons. If you don't have distress crayons, your distress inks will also work. If you want to use some acrylic paints, you can definitely use acrylic paints. To color the base, we are using the Home Decor chalk paint from Plaid, but if you want to use it from any other brand, it's perfectly alright. So what we are going to do first is, we are going to choose the Transforme sheets which we are going to use. Okay, so we have couple of options available here. So we have this butterfly, we have this another one which is called Beautiful Heaven, then we have these roses available, then we have this Queen Birds, then we have this lace collection. So you must be wondering how to get the information more about these sheets. So it's here. Let's understand the packaging first. So this is the sheet and this is how it comes. The sheet comes with a back card where if you just see, all the designs which you will be getting in the sheet is mentioned over here. And every step is given here in details. That is step number 1, step number 2 to step number 6. After that, you have a special code, you know, which will be coming with the sheet. This code is pasted over here because these are some of the old sheets. But in the new sheets, you will be getting this code already printed on this back card. What is this code all about? So this code is basically of group, which is a Transforme group, which is there on the Facebook itself. And there are thousands of people who are already a member of this group. By joining this group, you can definitely get a lot of inspirations for yourself. Not only that much, you have entire description written over here how to use the sheets as well. So this is how the Transforme sheets look like. Each Transforme sheet has its own unique name and own SKU, so you don't have to worry about, you know, finding it out with numbers. You can always remember the names and then you can use them. So what I'm going to do today is, I'm going to use this particular sheet which is called Beautiful Heaven, and I'm going to open and show more about it. So I have already taken out this sheet and, you know, taken out a small piece as well. Before I go ahead, I definitely want to tell you one thing, that when you see the sheet, you know, this is exactly the mirror image of the design here. That means whatever you can see here is the final design which you will be getting, and what you can see here is the mirror image of it. So what I have done is, I have done a small piece of cutting from here, and I'm just going to cut as near as possible. You don't have to really do a lot of fussy cutting, but you just have to cut which is very, very near to design, and you can just go randomly. You don't have to think much about it. It's very, very easy. So you can just get the results very quickly with these sheets. Now what we have done for your ease is, we have pre-cut few designs, and I'm going to show you to create the coasters in just no time. The first step I'm going to do for you guys is to paint this coaster. That's really important for you to paint the base, because if you don't paint the base, then you can't see the design on the top of it. So what I'm doing right now, I'm using a chalk paint, and with the help of a sponsor brush, you know, I'm covering it up. If you like to use the normal brush, you can do that, but then, you know, I feel that I get strokes with that, so I generally avoid using it. I mean, I prefer to use it with a sponge brush because it gives me a nice texture, and also it gives me a good coverage, so, you know, I feel like using this one. I think we all prefer beauty blenders these days rather than using the brushes, so I think this is one of the techniques which I even love on my coasters. So we have pre-painted the coaster with a chalk paint and we have dried them well. Definitely choice is yours, but we have done two coats to make sure, you know, the coating looks good. So what I'm going to do right now is, of course it's not a mandatory step, but just to give an extra color, an extra tinge of color, what we are doing is, we have taken this distress crayons. Since they are water reactive and, you know, they work very well when the water is sprayed, you can use them, or maybe you can use some distress inks as well. Choice is completely yours. It's your project, how you like it. I mean, there is no right and wrong in this project. So what you can do is, you can just add a tinge of color with the help of this distress crayons on the top of it. And once you think you are done and it's well spreaded, what you need to do is, you need to take a bottle of mister and you can just kind of spray it. This bottle is also from Dress My Craft, and I definitely want to tell you that this bottle is amazing because this is a German technology bottle, and it allows the water to spray on the surface very nicely. Once I've done this, I'm using my fingers. As you know, the fingers are the best tools to be used. So I'm using my finger and actually spreading it up. Definitely you can use the brush, whatever you like. It's your project, your choice at the end of the day. And this is how you can spread. For the second coaster, again, you know, you can take the color or you can even leave it raw. Or if you want to just use a single color, you can definitely use a single color as well. So what I'm doing is, I'm using a bit of single color on the top of it and not going to use any other color with the same. You can use like greens, you can use the browns, you can use the yellows, you can use the mustard, you can use anything. Again, I'm going to do the same thing. Take a spread. I love this bottle. I'm telling you, this is so amazing. The spray mechanism in this bottle is really, really amazing. So now what we are going to do is we are going to dry it up. Okay, so we have already dried them well with the help of a hair dryer, and as you can see, you have got the natural coloring beneath. Now what we are doing is, you know, we have taken this particular sheet and, you know, we have pre-cut this arborita flowers here and we are going to stick it like that. But as you can see, there are overlapping happening. Yes, you can do overlapping with the transfer me sheet. So, you know, I'm just trying to fix it up how exactly I'm going to use it. Once I'm happy with the placement, I'll definitely go ahead and, you know, place it. So what I am going to do now is the most important step. The most important step is, once you have pre-cut these sheets, you know, you always need to make sure that you peel off the protective film which is always there on the transfer me sheet. And as I said, this is your project, definitely your placement, whatever you like. There is nothing wrong, there is nothing right. So this is how I am placing right now. Now what I'm going to do is, I have taken a bowl of water and I have taken this damp sponge, and as you can see, there is a water inside it. And what I'll do is, I'll start dabbing this water against the surface. And if you can see, the design has started becoming transparent. That's the sign when you know that a sheet is getting wet and you are on the right path. And this is a time when you need to just make sure that you stop it there and then, so that you don't have extra water. Once you have done that, just keep that sponge aside. Soak whatever you have extra. This will help you to clear up your entire surface. And now once you have done that, what you need to do is, you just need to push a little bit. And as you can see, the color has started coming out, and as you can see, the magic has started happening below and the sheet has started sliding. Yes, if you just see, the sheet slided so well and so beautifully, and look, the entire design is transferred, and this is absolutely gorgeous. This is so amazing. Not only this, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to double layer it up, and now I'm going to use this beautiful sentiment on the top of it. You don't have to worry about anything going wrong with these transfer me sheets, because even if you're not happy, you can change the placements. If you're happy, you can keep the same placements as well. And now I've taken an extra butterfly, and just to add an extra glam to it, I'm adding the butterfly as well. So once I have done that, again I'm taking the sponge and, you know, damp it in the water. It's just the normal water. Please do not get worried about any particular solution or any other thing to be used. It's just the normal water which we are using. Once you have done that, and once it has seeped inside well, just, you know, make sure that it's becoming transparent. And once it starts becoming transparent, you can see that. And if you just see, oh my god, it's already started sliding. That means it's ready. Look at this one. Look, the design has already come. Look how beautiful it comes. So here it was straight, and here it's like a little bit tilted. So it doesn't really matter, because as I said, it's your project. How you like it, how you want to do it, definitely can do that. Once you have done this, I would suggest you to do a little bit splattering on the top of it. So what I'm using this plaid color. I think it's a black color. This is called Rich Black Home Decor Chalk Paint. What I have done is, I've taken a bit in my plate here, and I have mixed up a little bit water inside it, so that, you know, it becomes a little droopy. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm just take this one, and just with the help of this brush, you know, making sure I do not splatter too much. And you know, one thing, you can never control the splatters. You know that, right? So, you know, you don't have to really think about right and wrong. You just have to do it the way you like it. Wherever you find the empty spaces, you can just go ahead and make sure that you have done the splatter. If you don't like any particular splatter, for example, if this one, if you're not liking, just take a little bit of tissue and just kind of soak in. And in case if you're still not happy, just make sure you take a wet wipe and just clean it up. And that's all done. So this is one coaster, but when you want to do the another one, again, what you need to do is, as you can see in this basket, I have so many laces here. These are so beautiful laces which we have pre-cut. So look at this particular coaster here. You can create the same one. And what you need to do is, you need to take this beautiful lace, and of course you can cut it also, or maybe you can just paste it and then cut it. What you are going to do is, you're going to create the borders on the corner. And as you can see, these transfer me sheets look amazingly beautiful on all the surfaces. Now if you see, there is a little bit extra. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to chop off whatever I have extra. Okay, so once I have chopped off whatever I have extra, I have kept the transfer me sheet here. Now I'm going to pick up the queen bird. Let's copy the same. So I'm going to copy this one, but as you can see, this is a little bigger, so it's overlapping. So let's first finish this off. Again, take the sponge, dip in the water and then just dab it. This is so easy that even a kid can do it. This is so interesting that even an elder one can do it. This is so quick that everybody will be tempted to do. If you are short of time, in case if you are running somewhere and you need to give somebody a beautiful handmade gift, this is just a perfect thing. Look at this one. Once you have done that, again it's ready. And look at this beautiful, beautiful lace. Look at this, guys. This is so amazing. And now, just to layer it up, what I'm going to do is I am going to take another beautiful bird, which is called Queen Bird Sheets. In case if you need any help with the products used here, feel free to email us at info@dressmycraft.com. We are there for you. Look at this, guys. So look how beautiful it goes. And if you feel this is not looking nice to you, you can chop off, you can change the position, you can do anything, whatever you feel. And then again, if you wish to do a little bit splatter, you can do the splatters again. You can take the brush in your hand and then just do a little bit splatters. Not every time splatter is necessary. You can do the stamping, you can do the stenciling. As you can see, it's coming on the bird also. So what you can do is maybe you can just clean up from the bird. And this is only complete once you're going to varnish. So please, guys, make sure, you know, whenever you do the transforming sheet, you every time have to varnish it. For the varnishing purposes, I would highly recommend you to use a Mod Podge or maybe any liquid varnish or maybe a glossy scent, maybe a 3D lacquer or anything which has a 3D properties. You can also use a normal resin as well. I'm sorry, not every time you need a 3D property. You can also use a normal Mod Podge as well. You can use normal Mod Podge, satin, gloss, glitter. You can add glitter on the top of it also. You can add glitter here and then you can do the Mod Podge as well. As you can see, we have added glitter here on these butterflies. And then, you know, we have let it dry. And then we have poured resin on the top of it. And as you can see in these laces, we have even covered this with the help of the coloring part. Here we have done some grungy thing, here we have done some stenciling, here as you can do we have splatters, we have colors, here if you see we again have splatters, you know, here if you see we have done some doily techniques. I'm sure once you guys are going to use this transformation, you will get addicted to them. They're so amazing.